Hello and welcome everybody, I am Brandon, and today we're going to talk about that DualSense controller that Sony just dropped yesterday. They actually dropped it right before the Xbox Insider stream, which I thought was kind of sipping the tea a little bit on their part. That being said, I got all the details and more for you on another episode of You Care About. I would definitely say that Sony did that move on purpose. I think they're trying to build up a little bit of hype right before that Xbox stream to kind of take away a little bit of the shine from it. I don't really think they had much of a competition anyway. Xbox didn't talk a whole lot about the Xbox Series X, except for the memory cards, which I might make another video for, and kind of going over some games and stuff that'll be coming out soon. You can catch all that news over on the stream I did yesterday for the live announcement. I streamed the whole thing with my buddy Peter. Pretty cool stuff. I'd go check it out if you haven't seen any of that stuff yet. Moving on, I really love how this controller looks. I totally think they nailed it. They were definitely listening to the fans a lot when it comes to designing this controller. I love that two-tone situation they're going for. Definitely seems like they're opening the door for possible customization of controllers, more color options, or even like limited edition versions like Xbox does a lot of the time. One of the first things you're gonna notice is that there's not an obnoxious big light bar on the front of the controller. They made it a lot more minimalistic, just putting a little bit of a light underneath the touch bar, which I think is very tasteful. I like the look of it. Once again, adds that whole futuristic feel of the controller. And of course, you can see that it's been slightly enlarged and widened, it looks like. Definitely resembling a lot more of like an Xbox controller, admittedly. I think they're trying to appeal to a little bit of a wider audience here. People with big hands have always complained that the PS4 controller is too small or too slim even. And it definitely seems like the direction controllers are going in nowadays are kind of for a little bit of a bulkier feel, so it fills out the hand a little bit more. I love that little curve they have to the grips on the controller. I think that's a little bit of a nod to the boomerang controller that was originally announced with the PS3. I could be wrong, but kind of gave me that feel.
That was very good.
And they once again mentioned that it will have haptic feedback, kind of like the Nintendo Switch controllers. They call it HD rumble on there, but it's the same thing. As well as these resistive triggers, which are really cool sounding. It's gonna allow the game developers to program a resistance into the triggers so that when you're pulling a bow back or even going through mud or something like that, it's gonna kind of give a resistance as if it's a little bit harder to pull on the trigger. Definitely a little bit gimmicky with the haptic feedback and stuff like that, but I think overall they're just little touches that are gonna make playing the game feel better. And I have no problem with that. They got USB-C on this, a microphone, a speaker, and even a 3.5mm headphone jack on the bottom of that thing for all you audiophiles. They did remove the share button, but they didn't really take it away. They're just making it into a create button now, which I imagine is gonna tie into some sort of video editing or maybe even photo editing suite that's gonna be built into the PS5. Pretty neat sounding if that is the case. Pretty cool little bit of hardware here, I gotta say. They've really packed a buttload of features, even if some of them are a little bit gimmicky. That's just what controllers do. And it genuinely seems like they've listened to the fans on a lot of instances here, kind of removing that big light that takes up a bunch of battery on the front of the thing, making it a little bit wider, so on and so forth. That all being said though, I'm very curious to know how much this controller is gonna cost. I feel like with all of that tech inside of there, it might get a little pricey, and controllers are already pretty pricey as is, so hopefully they can keep it around that $60 mark or so. And they only barely touched on how much battery life the thing has. As far as we're concerned, it lasts a good long while, is what Sony pretty much said to us, but we have no amount of time listed as of yet. Hopefully with that bigger size and kind of reducing down on the light on the front and all that stuff, it'll definitely help with the longevity of the controller. That was also a huge thing that people complained about with the PS4 all the time. You only get like 4 hours of battery life and it's gone. At least they didn't do what Microsoft did and are still making you put batteries in your controller like it's 1985 though. Wait a second though, computer, you said that your sister's the PS5, right?
Yes, Brandon, I just told you that last episode. You don't need to pretend like you don't remember.
You wrote this script, what are you talking about? Well, whatever, what are your thoughts on this DualSense controller?
I do not have any input devices that allow me to interact with the physical world, thus I cannot use the DualSense controller.
Ah, maybe we could bolt one of those beefy arms on there for good measure. Nothing? Okay, that's about enough out of you. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Brandon. This was another episode of the You care about on the DualSense controller. Let me know what you guys think down below. Do you love it? Do you hate it? What do you think about it? Anyway, if you like what I do, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more, and have a kick-ass week.